Hello dear students, hope you all are safe and sound at your home. Welcome to your maths class. I'll continue with the chapter ratio and proportion. So in your previous class you have learned about proportion, and today from this chapter you'll learn a very important topic, and the name of the topic is unitary method. Now what you have to know about this method. So what this method says, the method in which first we find the value of one unit and then value of required number of units is known as unitary method. So if you are confused, I am giving one example. Suppose I am telling you cost of 2 marker is rupees 20, right? So I am talking about the cost of 2 marker. Now suppose I am telling you find the cost of 4 markers. So in this method, first of all we find the value of 1 unit. So here they have told you the value of 2 units. So 2 units means the cost of 2 markers. Cost of 2 markers is rupees 20. So step 1, you have to find the cost of 1 marker. Means first you have to find the value of 1 unit. 1 unit means cost of 1 marker. So if the cost of 2 marker is rupees 20, cost of 1 marker is, yes you are right, 20 divided by 2, that is rupees 10. So cost of 1 marker when you have found, means you have found the value of 1 unit. Now what you have to do, then the value of required number of units. So what does it mean, required number of units? Required number of units means for how many marker the cost they have told you, they are telling you to find out. Here the required number of units is find the cost of 4 markers. So here required number of units means you have to find the cost of 4 markers. Since you have already found the cost of 1 marker, that is you have already found the value of 1 unit, that is rupees 10. Now how you can find the cost of 4 markers? So if cost of 1 marker is rupees 10, cost of 4 marker will be, yes, when you know the value of less and you want to find the value of more, you have to do multiplication, that you have already learned. So when you know cost of 1 marker is rupees 10, cost of 4 marker will be 4 multiplied 10, that is rupees 40. So by using this method we can solve many important types of word problems. So children, I hope you all like this method and you all have understood about unitary method.